Hey, welcome into the round pen with Aquatoss. You can see we got a bit of rain last night. This is the end of his fourth week of training. And so he made a lot of good progress on a lot of things. I'll tack on to the end of one of these videos, me picking up his feet a little bit yesterday. And his feet are pretty bad, and hopefully next week I can get some trimming done on them. And basically, I'm going to go ahead and start moving him around here, and then I'll tell you a few things. So if you watched the very first video from almost 4 weeks ago, when I was trying to round pin him a little bit, it was a kind of a train wreck. And so I didn't do it again. I didn't do it again for about 2 weeks, and then when I came back to it, I've just been doing really low-key sessions like this, and I'm not even asking him to lope, I'm just asking him to trot, and that's him spooking at nothing over there on the other side of the fence. So why do we round pin a horse like this? Mainly what I'm trying to do is establish a connection with him that I can control his movements without a rope. So I don't want him to think the rope is in charge. I want him to think I'm in charge. Okay, see, I didn't ask him to lope, but he's doing okay. He's not trying to jump over the fence. And I don't want him changing directions unless I ask him to. So doesn't take much pressure to move this horse. And I know a lot of folks thought I put too much pressure on him on that first day and scared him too much. Folks, he wasn't scared. He was scared before I did anything, okay? So my point was I needed to get him where he's not scared, where he can just do this. And see, he's not paying attention to me right there. He wouldn't have kept going, okay? Ooh. There, he kind of paid attention, okay? Now, this is not a beautiful round pinning demonstration. We're not going to get that out of him. But I'm fairly satisfied with that. He's mostly paying attention to me. And the mares are standing right there, so he's always got distractions. And you know, you may say, well, why don't you move the mares, you big dummy? Because it's life, okay? It's life. This horse needs to learn to do what he's supposed to do regardless of distractions. And he can do that, and he is doing it, okay? So I'm pretty satisfied with that. And he'll hook onto me and follow me around if I ask him to. That's not really a deal. To me, that's, you know, that's okay. I don't know if he'll do it here or not. With the mares right there, he'd probably choose them over me. Back up. Okay. All right. There you go. There, he might come with me. No, he's not. So just made a liar out of me over that. He would much rather go kiss her than he would talk to me. Oh, you gonna come over? Give me yours. Okay. As far as the danger part, I would say I'm about probably 90% of that is gone unless something scares him. Okay, just under normal circumstances, if you're just leading him around, going from one place to another, you know, feeding him whatever, he's pretty good. I don't see him. I think he's to the point now that a reasonably competent horse person could handle him. I mean, I wouldn't let my six-year-old granddaughter start leading him around, but in, you know, somebody that knows horses could probably handle him okay. If he gets scared, then it's Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde time. And I'm going to check something out here in a minute. Let me just go through, because I do this pretty much every day. I just go back and redo everything I've done before. Throw the ropes around his legs. Okay, so I want him to just be bored stiff over this kind of stuff. And he still flinched just a little bit. And it's first thing in the morning and it's cold and it rained last night. So he's a little goosier than normal. It's okay. So my task with him is twofold. The first task, which is mostly what I've worked on up till now, is just teaching him manners. how to lead, how to back up, you know, teaching them basic manners. My second task, and the one that's quite a bit more difficult, is teaching him to control his emotions so that he doesn't seriously overreact every time he gets a little bothered by something. And boy, he can get bothered in a hurry. So you may have seen my session with him the first time I introduced the flag to him, and I think I even had a second session there. And so this is maybe fourth or fifth time, and it's a whole lot better. Okay, he's kind of gotten used to that. It's not perfect by any means, but it's a whole lot better. Okay, he can kind of handle that. And this is how I teach him to handle his emotions. It's a bunch of different things to get him just a little bothered. And I'm going to show you a little scale I use that kind of helps me think about this. I think of a horse's emotions on a scale of 0 to 10. 0 is asleep, and 10 is an absolute blind panic, which this horse can do, by the way. So they're always on that scale somewhere. If they're just out in the pasture eating grass, they're on a level 1. If they're, if you walk up to them and say hi, that goes up to about a level 2 if they're a broke horse. Okay, so right now, his emotions have gone up to about a level 3 on that scale, maybe 4. He's a little bit anxious, his head's up, he's a little bothered, but he's not panicking or anything like that. And if you get to the top of that scale, basically 8, 9, or 10, I actually like I had to tap him to get him to move with this flag. When you get up to the 8, 9, 10 range, then that horse is in a blind panic. And you saw this horse do that on the first video. If you haven't seen it, you can go back and watch part 1 with this horse. And he was in a blind panic. Probably a level, at least a 9, if not a 10, which means he's not thinking at all. He's just total reacting. And then he did it again, and this caught me off guard. So I've been trying to avoid that the last 4 weeks. I don't want him doing that. What I want to do is I want to take his emotions up to about a 5 or a 6, which is about where he is right now, and then teach him that he can live through it. Good boy. And then let him stop and lick and chew. So that when he's licking and chewing, if he was up to a 6, now he's coming down to a 5, 4, right there, about a 3, so he's come back down. All right, and then I'll do the same thing again. I'll take him back up, so I'll send him the other way. So he's at a level 3, 4, 5, doing a little better, okay. Ooh, okay. So horses learn, they don't learn at the bottom of the scale when they're asleep or eating grass, and they don't learn when they're in a total panic because they're not thinking at all, they're just reacting, it's all emotion. They learn in about the 3 to 7 range of emotions. That's where they learn. They're still, which is where he is right now, so he's learning this stuff, okay? He's learning this stuff, good. So I'm real happy with that.
I think I'm to the point where I can pick his feet a little bit. I was able to do just a little bit a few minutes ago, but I kind of wanted y'all to see his feet because they're about as bad as I've ever seen. This could explain a lot of why he especially favors this front right foot. So I'm going to square him up here and see if he'll pick it up for me. I'm going to have zoom in on his foot. If you can see that, so that's this horse that's not had his feet picked, but he's doing pretty well. See this growth here? It's like he's walking on a ball. I seriously doubt if these feet have ever been trimmed. He's a little nervous. I had him a little more relaxed earlier. When he's relaxed, he does pretty well. When he gets nervous, he doesn't do as well, do you, bud? Let's try it again. Yeah. But you
See if she can zoom in on this foot.
I'd like you to see the bottom of it. The backs are not quite the same, but they're almost as bad. He's going to pack himself into this fence. So that's going to be a challenge.